an untrue version of history has been passed to generations. Despite all adversities, some people who are not afraid to tell the truth still live.
A
Turkish friend saved my father. He took him to the Russian army, traveling on foot for 3 nights and 3 days. Sometimes, when the subject opened, when we had guests or the conversation got deeper, my father's eyes would fill with tears and he would say, "The Turks were good." Turkish villagers always had good intentions towards Armenians. The Turkish villagers, even the whole Turkish nation, were so good to Armenians, and Armenians were close to them. But the Kurds, they took advantage of this. They did very bad things. They raided us. They would even steal the things we carried. They were plunderers.
An Armenian who saw the truth himself tells about the Turks in immigration years. But there is another truth, the murders committed by those who claim to have been subjected to genocide. Blood and tears remained from the assassinations conducted by Armenian terrorists against Turkish government officials and innocent Turkish citizens in many places of the world. Danish Tunalıgil, Turkish ambassador in Vienna, was only one of those killed by Armenian terrorists.
Burada da Ermeni dostlarım var. Hepsi benim başlarını önüne yiyorlar benim karşımda.
I have Armenian friends as well here. They all lower their heads in front of me. It's because they're guilty. It's not something they want. They're sad and they're grieving. In fact, this Asallah is making a mistake. They're harming their own country, not especially us. They're sowing discord. They don't want us to get along, to be friends. This means they're not real Armenians. I believe so. I don't feel hatred against Armenians. That was another group. For me, Armenians are different. Asallah is different. Asallah is something else.
Asallah ayrı bence. Asallah başka bir şey.
A Turkish woman whose diplomat husband was killed by Asallah says it would be wrong to identify Armenians with terrorists. She says Armenians and Turks are friends. On the other hand, an Armenian scientist...
If somebody shot my brother and killed him, I wouldn't even go to court. I wouldn't tell anyone. If I had a gun in my hand, I would immediately kill the murderer.
Those who, in the past, dressed up their children in the uniforms of Armenian rebels, donned with arms and knives, make their children take oaths for vengeance at school today. They crowd monuments installed in the name of an unproven genocide.
The Armenian school, which is our hope, is the basis of our example. We educate and surround our new generation with the Armenian spirit there.
In Armenia and Armenian schools outside Turkey, young hearts are made to take vengeance oaths.
Some of my Armenian friends during our dialogues told me about how from age 2, as they're growing up and they're developing their individual identities, they're also told that their identities are dependent on how they are different from the Turks and how they are victimized by the Turks. So that their personal developmental identity and this identity's relationship with the other have become almost a normal thing for them. Thus, when such a person becomes an adult, he or she almost psychologically is obliged to be preoccupied with this type of identity.
The whole world is talking about the clash of religions and civilizations along with terrorism, which have turned into a global threat today. Were religion or sex influential over incidents in the past as well?
I have no doubt that all the religious problems we are facing now are an imposition stemming from religious difference.
I believe missionaries played a great role. Relations deteriorated after the 1840s and 50s.
Rolü olduğuna ben inanıyorum.
Armenians compare their allegations with the Jewish genocide. How does that fit into international law? How do Jews who lived the genocide evaluate the Armenian issue?
The Jewish experience in World War II particularly, where the full power of an industrial state like Germany was trained upon a single people for no other crime except for no crime except that they were Jewish, and where of the 6 million people who died, over 1.5 million were children under 12 years old, we think is unique. There has been nothing like it in history.
Today, Armenians who try to identify their situation with Jews seem to forget the murders conducted by their ancestors against the Jews. Armenians who served as Nazi officers in Hitler's army played a major role in this blood-covered page of history. In Caucasia, there were Armenian troops in the service of Nazi Germany and Armenian journals supporting the Nazi regime.
Hitler's famous quote, "Who remembers the Armenians?" Well, I can tell you exactly who remembered the Armenians. It was Hitler. I'm about halfway through with the next book in my series I'm doing, and my working title is Hitler's Armenian Nazis. And there were over 100,000 of them volunteered starting in 1935 to fight for Aryan purity with the Nazis. They even had a radio broadcast from Berlin once a week, and there were over 500 of them. They had newspapers. So when you come up with a fake document, which nobody can really verify that it just showed up like, well, Hitler said this. Well, Hitler also remembered the Armenians. And when he proclaimed them in 1943 to be Aryan pure, just like the Germans would, and it was the Armenians who lobbied Hitler to declare them to be Aryan pure. And when you look at Armenia today, it is Aryan pure. It's over 95% pure Armenian. They've driven everybody else out. And by law, you can't even, if you're a minority, you can't hold a public office in Armenia, just like the Nazis did. So they got to know their partners in crime well during those 1935 to 1945 for 10 years, and they're practicing it today. So, yeah, Hitler... Remember the Nazis, they were his partners. And I think that needs to be told.
The genocide allegations are used as the philosophical foundation for the establishment of a greater Armenia, much spoken of by Armenians. They wish to disrupt the territorial integrity of a country.
As both Armenians from Aleppo and as Armenians gathered from Mardin, Marash, Kozan, Malatya, and Sivas, we all believe that Cilicia is our homeland, and we claim those houses as our fair legacy.
We who live in the United States are going to have to give up all of our land to the Mexicans, because they had Texas and several other states, and the rest of us in the other parts of the United States are going to have to go back to Europe because the Native Americans owned that before they did. So if you take the Armenian logic to its conclusion, none of us belong any place.
That some Armenians want to establish a greater Armenia on Turkish territory is against international law and national sovereignty rights.
The Kars Agreement is a legacy from the Soviet Union. Therefore, as a successor state, Armenia should have adopted the agreement. However, Armenia remains silent on the issue. She does not adopt the agreement.
In various parts of Anatolia, there are mass graves belonging to Turks. Scientists witness today the results of massacres conducted by Armenians in Hakmemet village in Urdur.
In particolare c'era un villaggio, il villaggio di Hakmemet.
There was one village especially, Hakmemet village. I went to that village, a mass grave was found, and there lay the Turks that were killed during the incidents. There were about 30 people, and these were young women. We could tell from their clothes.
Massacrati durante questa questione.
He had his 21 or 22-year-old son with him. The Armenians said, "Let's slay your son as a sacrifice to God for you." They said that.